live from the campus of Washington and Lee University. This is a Channel 18 Rockbridge News Update.
Welcome to the Rockbridge Report live news update. I'm Reed Gady. On Monday, the United States and 11 other nations agreed on a major trade deal called the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Full details of what the agreement entails will not be released for another several weeks. The deal is a major legacy victory for President Barack Obama, but opponents of the deal, such as American labor groups, worry that the agreement will result in American jobs being sent overseas. President Obama has to wait 90 days before he can sign the pact. Congress is not expected to vote on the deal until well into next year. South Carolina is heading into its fourth day of flooding, and there's no sign of the water letting up. CNN's Jan Pomerenz reports.
We still have to be cautious the next 36 to 48 hours, just because there is no rain and just because the sun is out. We are now looking at downstreams, waters, and other areas that are going to be affected.
South Carolina continues to grapple with the consequences of extreme weather plaguing the region. Hundreds of roadways and bridges remain closed, and 18 dams are being monitored throughout the state. Nine have breached or failed since Saturday, forcing people to evacuate their homes.
Everything was underwater. The water level rose above the top of the dining room table.
Residents who have been able to return are finding furniture and personal items scattered outside. Some apartments have even been looted.
Their stuff is gone. It's just overwhelming.
At the end of the day, at least we are all still here and nobody, you know, lost their life or anything like that.
A local cemetery flooded, separating headstones from the ground and unearthing caskets. And the problems are far from over.
We've got a long way to go, but we'll get there. We got to do it together, but we still have a long way to go.
In Columbia, South Carolina, I'm Jan Pomerenz reporting.
At least 13 people have died so far, and officials estimate damage at more than $1 billion. Earlier today, General John Campbell, the commander of U.S. forces in Afghanistan, appeared before a Senate committee. Campbell answered questions about the U.S. airstrike that hit a Doctors Without Borders hospital on Saturday in the city of Kunduz. The strike killed 12 medical staff members and at least 10 patients, including 3 children. Another 37 people were wounded, according to Doctors Without Borders. Tomorrow, Washington and Lee University will host a debate between the candidates for Rockbridge County and the City of Lexington Commonwealth's attorney. Republican Chris Bilius will face off against independent Joshua Elrod at 7:30 p.m. in the moot courtroom inside the W&L Law School. The debate is expected to last around 45 minutes. Thanks for tuning in to the Rockbridge Report live news update. Tune in Thursday at 4:30 for our full broadcast. We'll give you the latest regarding the drug roundup that took the county by storm last week, and also provide a recap of Wednesday's Commonwealth's attorney debate. You can also get the latest on rockbridgereport.washingtonandlee.net. Thanks for staying updated, and have a good night.